Hello everyone, today's lesson is lesson 12, lines, number lines, and tally marks. So mathematics, we study numbers, but we also study shapes like circles, squares, and triangles. The study of shapes is called geometry. The simplest figure in geometry are the point and the line. Okay. A line does not end. It goes on forever in both directions, which is why we have the arrows. Okay. A line segment is part of a line. Okay, and it has a beginning and an end, and it's shown by dots. Okay. The segments can be drawn without dots. It just depends on how we want it to look. Okay. And then a third type is a ray. An array begins at a point and then continues on forever. Okay. This is what each of those look like. And a point, of course, is just a point is a dot. Okay. All right. So lines, rays, and segments, they can be horizontal, which means they go from left to right across the horizon. They can be vertical, which means they go up and down. Or they can be oblique. And oblique means that they're slanted, they go in any direction except for horizontal or vertical. Okay. All right, a number line is a line that shows numbers at certain distance from zero. On this number line, we have the numbers from zero to positive 10 and from zero to negative 10. Okay. The space or distance between each numbers is what we call a unit segment, because it's just one segment of the whole line. And the numbers to the left of the zero, we call these negative numbers. And the numbers to the right of zero are called positive numbers. Okay, so and negative numbers have a little dash to show that they are negative. The numbers shown on the number line are called integers. Okay. Integers include all the counting numbers, the negatives, zero, and the positives. Okay, so this sequence counts down by ones. Write the next six numbers in the sequence and say the numbers aloud as a class. Okay, so we go 5, 4, 3, and our next numbers would be 2, 1, 0, and then we go to the negative. So we go -1, -2, -3. Okay, so that would be my next six sequences. Okay, so notice that as a number gets farther away from zero in the negatives, the negative number gets bigger. Okay, all right, so this says draw a number line marked with whole numbers from 0 to 5. So I'm going to start off by drawing my line. Okay, and then I'm going to make a tick mark for the number 0. And I'm going to make a tick mark for each number and try to make these as evenly spaced as possible. You can use a ruler to do this. I'm just going to do it freehand and do the best I can. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is what my number line would look like. Okay, so this says how many unit segments are there from 2 to 5 on the number line in example 2. So we go back to this and we want to go from 2 to 5. So I'm going to count the number segments starting at 2. So there's 1, 2, 3. So I have 3 segments between the numbers 2 and 5. On this problem, it says, on the number line below, arrows A and B indicate integers. Write the two integers using a comparison symbol to show which integer is greater. Okay, so first we have to figure out what these are. So starting at 0, we're going to count the units to the left. So we have 1, 2, 3. So that means A is at -3. Now we're going to count the to the right to find B. So starting at 0 again, we go 1, 2. So B is at 2. So which number is, we want to compare them, so which number is bigger? Well, between negative 3 and 2, negative 3 means I have less than 0 things. So that means that negative 3 is less than 2. Okay. All right. For the last part of this lesson, we talk about tally marks. So tally marks are used to keep track of a count. Okay. Each tally mark counts as 1. So 1 tally mark would be 1. 2 tally marks would be 2. This would be 3. 4. And then when we get to 5, we connect it, the fifth tally mark goes across the middle, like that. And then 6 would look like that with one more. So 6 has 5 tally marks and then a single tally mark. Okay, so let's look at this. We have 5, 10, 15, 16, 17. So I have 17 tally marks in this picture. Okay. What if I have a couple more tally marks? All right, so what would that number be? Well, so we count by fives. We have 5, 10, 15, 20, then 21, 22, 23. Okay, and that's it for this lesson. Good luck on your homework.